Every time a sci-fi action movie wants to blow our minds with futuristic technology, there is nothing they love more than nanotechnology.
You like it?
Well, it is time to break the myth, because nanotech has been part of our lives for decades now. All the way from food industry, to medical practices, to self-healing materials, this is how humans are mastering biology and changing our lives forever. This is Yonka, welcome to another episode of Blank Note. When we talk nanotech, we are not necessarily referring to those tiny swarms of nanoscopic robots covering us in an iron suit. More realistically, we are talking materials. Molecules purposely engineered to behave in a specific way. How small? Take a millimeter and split it in 1,000 parts, and you will obtain a micrometer. Here we find bacteria, viruses and cells. Take 1 micrometer and split it in 1,000 parts, and that is how you obtain a nanometer. That is how you would measure cell membranes. Yeah, that's how cool humans are. From the absolute best ways this technology is used, medical practices is the one we should be more enthusiastic of. Those who battle cancer know how terrible of a condition that is, because most of the time even the remedy itself is a painful one. The way chemotherapy works is by bombarding all of the body in hopes of breaking down the cancer cells present in the system, putting even healthy ones in serious stress. Well, nanotech therapies instead can be programmed to attack only sick cells, sparing the healthy tissue. The size at which they operate makes them great vessels to transport treatment as well. And this sort of targeted medical system can be of course applied to every other internal diagnose. In the decades to come, nanotechnology will bring us systems of nanobots present at all times in our system, monitoring every aspect of our health. And since the science operates at such a tiny scale, it is only a matter of time until we start navigating neurons, understanding the brain more, and even introduce new therapies to mental conditions. Health is a serious issue, of course, but dropping your expensive newly bought phone, picking it up only to find out that you reduce its value to half, is a serious pain as well. What if I tell you that in the future, your precious iPhone screen will repair itself? Scientists from the Israel Institute of Technology were working with double perovskite nanocrystals when they discovered they were capable of healing damage to their structures under the right conditions. Basically, the crystals can push the voids to the side, reuniting themselves automatically, therefore healing solid surfaces just like bones do. You will not see this feature in the next generation of Gorilla Glass, but hopefully it will be a reality in some years. The physics equation of friction forces will always require us to develop lighter but at the same time tougher materials. That is exactly what nanotechnology offers. Scientists from Michigan State University have crafted a system of separating layers of graphite into sheets less than 10 nanometers thick. The material, called exfoliated graphite nanoplatelles, can be used in its own or combined with other elements to produce stronger and more fuel-efficient cars and even rockets, which are lighter but strong enough to get into space. The material is also electrically and thermally conductive, and small enough to be incorporated in transparent surfaces, meaning it could be used in the energy sector, creating new batteries or solar panels coating. Obviously, energy and the more sustainable ways we harvest it is absolutely one of this generation of science's biggest concern. While we figure this should be big technology out in the open, windmills, dams and so on, nanotech wants to gather energy from you. Scientists from the University of Texas have created a form of yarn composed of nanofibers which can translate kinetic energy, aka movement, into electric energy. So maybe in the future, a simple walk in the park could charge your phone. Once the concept gets applied in the macro, we could see every kind of movement as a potential energy source. And since this kind of science is so good at operating in the molecule level, one interesting way to clear the atmosphere from the excess amount of carbon dioxide comes from a startup called Sky Nano. The company has developed an electrochemical process that captures gaseous CO2 emissions and converts them into solid carbon nanotubes. Once turned into solid state, the material can be recycled or even stored away for as much as 1,000 years. And the examples stretch on to nearly every other sector of life, from water purification, food processing, gadgets, and so on. In conclusion, the most fascinating part of the subject is the ability of human species to master the art of operating in such a minuscule scale, right at the layer where biology happens. We are now able to alter the nature of atoms, forge it to our benefits. And every step we take further in this direction is, no question, a step closer to understanding how nature works, take more control over the planet or the universe itself, and overall bring in a better future to next generations. Alright, that's it for this video. Don't hesitate to share thoughts. Hit the thumbs up button if you liked it and subscribe for more. Thank you. Catch you in the next one.